Hi, I'm Brandon Ulrich from B2i Healthcare, and today I'm going to show you some features of our terminology authoring platform, Snowall. When I say that Snowall is a platform, what I mean is that it's designed to be easy to add new terminologies and to customize Snowall for your particular organization and requirements. If you have any questions or comments on these screencasts, or if you'd like to request access to Snowall, we'd love to hear from you. Just drop us a note at snowall@b2international.com, and we'll send you some additional information. If you go to the Help menu, you can choose Help Contents to view Snowall's help system. The help system actually is available both as online help, as a user guide in a PDF format, and it's available online as well. Please check out our website if you'd like to download any of these. Well, let's jump right in and try filtering the SnowMed CT Contents view by entering Amoxi in the SnowMed CT Contents view. We see the list of matching results in a flat list that uses an icon to identify the top-level concept. If instead we'd prefer to see the information arranged hierarchically by the top-level concept, we can click the toggle between flat list and tree icon. Since the hierarchies can be deep, it's often useful to be able to set a lower-level concept as the root within the concepts view. For example, I can set the co-amoxiclave as a root concept by selecting it and then clicking the set concept as root icon. Another type of window is called an editor. If I open SnowMed CT Concept Editor by double-clicking a concept, I'm going to open the SnowMed CT Concept Editor. Editors are always displayed in the central editor area, and they're always tied to an edited resource. For example, in this case, a SnowMed CT concept, but also a reference set or a mapping. Any number of editors can be opened at once, but only one can be active at a time. The main menu bar and toolbar for the workbench window contain operations that are applicable to the active editor. Tabs at the top of the editor area indicate the names of resources that are currently open for editing. An asterisk on a tab indicates that the editor has unsaved changes. Some editors contain multiple pages. You can switch between them by clicking on the tabs at the bottom of the editor. You can drag columns around to size them to your preferences, or double-click them if you'd like them to auto-fit. You can also customize the columns of the editor window in the Preferences panel. To access the preferences, go to the Snowall menu and select Preferences. Windows user will find the same Preferences command in the File menu. We'd like to change the preferences for the SnowMed CT editor, so we first navigate to it and then adjust its settings. Each column's value can include both text and an icon, one or the other, or be completely disabled. One of the reasons you might want to do this is, for example, with the status icon. The icon itself is sufficient to identify whether something is active or inactive, so if you're using a small monitor, it's sometimes nicer just to use the icon. We can return to the root concept by clicking the Return to Root Concept icon. Clicking the X icon within the search view will clear the filter text. I think this turns out to be an eraser on Windows systems. If you have an expanded tree and you want to collapse everything so that the nodes are smaller, you can click the minus icon to do that for you. To reduce the number of keystrokes, you can enter only the first few characters of words that you're searching for in a multi-word expression. For example, you can enter BLPSTSY to find standing systolic blood pressure. If there's only a single concept active, pressing return will open it up in the editor. It's worth noting that all descriptions are considered during filtering, not only the preferred terms. And you can also use the filter to look up a concept by its ID. Views support editors and provide alternate presentations as well as ways to navigate the information in your workbench. You can see the available views by selecting Window, Show View. A view might appear by itself or stacked with other views in a tabbed notebook. You can resize and arrange views by dragging them to different docking positions in the workbench window. Views can also have their own menus and toolbars. The actions represented by buttons on view toolbars only affect the items within that view. Double-clicking a view's tab will maximize or restore it to its previous size. A perspective defines the initial set and layout of views in Snowall. You can select a perspective by choosing Window, Open Perspective. If you'd like to reset your current layout to the default settings, you can choose Window, Reset Perspective. This means that as you're playing around and you mess up your workbench, it's not such a big deal to go back and reset the defaults. In addition to the default layout, you can also drag views to different positions and save this layout as a new perspective by choosing Window Save Perspective As. This allows you to create a different layout for different tasks you might perform in a different role. For example, when mapping SNOMED CT concepts to ATC codes, it may be useful to have the SNOMED CT concepts view on the far left side of the screen, the ATC concepts view on the far right side of the screen, and the editor window between them to simplify dragging and dropping concepts to the map editor. Once we've created our new layout, we can save it as a new perspective. To switch between perspectives, choose Open Perspective from the Window menu. This allows me to choose either the default arrangement or any customized perspectives that I've created particular to my role. I think we'll leave it at that for the introductory screencast. If you have any comments or questions, or suggestions for additional screencasts, please send them to us at snowall@b2international.com. In the meantime, don't forget the online help if you have any questions about a particular feature. And thanks a lot for watching. Bye.